Hey guys, welcome back. We are now on week 9 of this project that we've been doing. Excuse my breathlessness, I've been trying to quickly choreograph something to teach you guys today. as I say every week, do not be like me, be more organised. How lucky are you guys now? You guys, I think all of you, or at least most of you, can now see your friends. You can now go and see your friends, and you can go and play with them, and you can hug them, and it's great to hear. It's good that you guys can get back to playing with each other and having fun now, rather than it just being yourselves and doing online gaming and things like that, and just talking to people over the phone. You know, you can now see your friends and hug them and tell them you miss them and show them how much you miss them. Unfortunately, people like me who are much older, we still need to unfortunately wait quite a while before we can do that. But I'm hoping that it'll change soon. I'm hoping. But please do get out there, hug your friends, tell them you miss them, show them how much you mean to them, because it'll mean a lot to some people. It'll mean a lot to some people knowing that you were thinking of them and that you mean a lot to them. And I'm saying that because that's what I want for my friends. anyway, enough about that. I have a little something choreographed, but we'll take a longer warm-up and we'll take a longer cool-down today. But I do have something planned, but it might take me a while to teach it, so we'll see how that goes. And if it doesn't, then you guys will see the hot mess again of me trying to choreograph something for you on the spot. So remembering our water, taking drinks when we need to, taking rests when we need to, all that kind of stuff. So let's get, excuse me, to a warm up. Let's do this one. I've not done this one in a while. So feet apart, head up. Chest. This is all hands on deck. Calling out to love. Watch one side. I'm getting tired of the disrespect. We won't stop to free rule the world. What's my name? What's my name? Other side. Underneath your hips, parallel, most such as knee bends. Keep your body upright. Go faster. Sorry. March in the spot. They say I'm bad. Fight in my belly. So don't make me mad. He's up. Dirty, no good. Down to the bone. I'll take that trophy back to my soul. Back to marching in. My fashion's wicked. Hair's off my gloves. Like John's kicking backwards. Okay, I don't know why that's happened. To excuse my elderly pains. It's kind of come out of nowhere, so just need to be careful with the rest of my day. So we finished last week looking at pirouettes. So looking at going up onto a releve on your supporting leg, whatever supporting leg that may be, whether it's your left or your right, and your hands are in here and jazz forth, tightly in, not here, in here, because it's a very quick single we need to do. And we have our foot in next to our knee to here. We're keeping it in parallel. We're not trying to do a tree pose in yoga, because that's putting pressure on our knee and we do not need that. And I did not need to do that, as I've now got a dirty foot mark on the inside of my leg. In here, so your foot should be facing me, but touching your knee of the other leg. So that's your pirouette. And we're only doing one of them, and we're kind of falling off it at the end, and we're going into the next section. So let's try what we've learned so far. We'll do it a few times and then we'll move on to the next section. Over the behind side front, so remembering when you do, you're out to the side and in to the front and in, you're then going straight into your behind side front. So your behind side front into your preparation, into your pirouette. I can't remember if I went over the arms, so I'll go over the arms really quickly. So as you're doing your behind side front, your arms, depending on what leg you're doing, I'll do the left leggers first, so this is the side I go on. So as you're stepping your left foot behind, the left arm's going to come in front of you and basically do that. So I'll show that again. The left arm's going to come from here, across, over the front of your body, out to the side here. Do not do this. I see a hand doing this, I'll chop it off. I mean it. It hurts to even show you doing this. It needs to be out to the side here, so that the line continues from your shoulder all the way to your fingertip. I'll show that again. Over here, to the side. Your right hand is going to come from here. It's going to go round the back of you to here. Well, to the side. So really it's here, to the side, to the front here. And again, none of this. It's here. Long line from the shoulder all the way down to the fingertip. So both arms at the same time. So have your hands down the front here. All you're going to do, if you're the right side, do not worry about this, I will go over the right side. So here, your hands are basically doing that, both going that way, and should end up here. Okay, so I'll do that again slowly. Hands down in front. They're going across your body here, over the front of your face. From here, your left's going down here and your right's coming down in front of you. So they're both doing their own circles. They're just a little bit different. One more time. Across here to here. Okay? Left leggers, have a practice of that whilst I go through the right leggers. So right leggers use the exact same thing, just the other way. So as you're doing your right behind side front, your right hand is doing the across the body and out to the side. Okay, so your right hand, it's the same arm as the leg you're stepping back to do your behind side front, goes across your body, over your face, and out to the side. Again, not this, here. Your left hand is doing the side one. So it's going out to the side, up and over your head, and out to the front. Long line from the shoulder to the fingertip. Now I'm not used to doing this side, so I apologise if it's a bit messy. So across the body. To here. Yeah, I had to think about that. I had to think about that there. I'll do that again, sorry. Across the body, over the face, to here. I'll try it with the feet. It'll be messy, but it should go. One and two. Okay, yeah, all right. I'll do that again. Hopefully I'll go back here so you can see my feet. So right leggers go one and two. Left leggers do one and two. Not bad, considering that my left leg's my better leg. And that's fast, so don't worry about it being really, really balletic and soft. It's kind of fast, kind of, it's like jazz. It's kind of jazz, kind of hip hop fusion sort of thing. Wow. Suddenly the sun's come out of nowhere and I'm dying. Why did I wear black? I need to invest in brighter clothes for you guys, because all I ever do is wear black or grey. I need to fix that. Anyway, so you have done. What have you done? What did you just do? Your two walks. You do here, walk, walk to the side and in to the front and in straight into your behind side front from here. So your feet should be in parallel on a demi-plie, and you're either going one and two, or you're either going one and two. Makes more sense in my head, hopefully it will make sense to you. So whatever side you do it on, it's step, step, prepare, snap into one pirouette. From there, whatever leg it is that you support, so the leg that stays on the floor when you're doing your turn, it's going to snap out to the side, to here, and you're going to bring it in, like that. Right leggers, that will be here. Okay? Do not worry about it being really clean, because again, it's short. Now, I only did that because I tend to fall off of my pirouettes quite a lot. So I thought, if you guys are doing the same thing, I will give you a move to help cover that and make it look like it's part of it. Okay? Let's try the whole thing with that added in. Come on! It's fast. Let's try that once more. As always, if you're not getting these moves right away, do not worry about it. It took me forever. To be fair, I'm still getting it. So, I'm going to let the music play a couple of times, just so you guys can have a practice yourselves, and then we'll go on to the next section. so we're doing alright for time. So you guys just practice your pirouettes, practice the sequence, and then we'll be focusing on the next bit. Don't worry about what I'm doing. So after you finish your pirouette, whether it's here, into here, you're gonna start rolling your shoulders back, taking a couple of wee steps, just so you can get yourself in a good space again, whenever you're doing this. Because you will most likely be either too far forward or too far back. And you will definitely need to be in the middle for the next bit. I do apologize, my t-shirt's not behaving. So you do this for two counts of eight, okay? Now, next bit might be a bit tricky, hence why I wanted to try and get this done today. Your feet are hip width apart, like we do in our warm-ups. Your hands and fists, they're going to go as such. One and two, okay? Right, left, right. Yeah. Right, left, right. I need to really break this down. Hold on. Right. Right, left, right. Left, right. Left arm goes down. No. Wait. The right, left, right. Left, right to here. Left arm is down, right arm's up. Elbows are tucked in. Right, left, right, tuck. If you want to call it that. Do that again. Right, left, right, tuck. Bring your elbows together almost. The sun has come out of nowhere. I'm not prepared. I don't have my umbrella. Ugh. Right, left, right, tuck. You will be moving over side to side when you're doing this. So you're doing over to the right, over to the left. Do that again. Over to the right, over to the left. That's quite fast. It should be one and two, three and four. It's fast. Sorry. One more time. Right and right, left and tuck. From there, you then stand back to the middle. Right arm out to one side, left arm out to one side. I think I did do the inversion of a knee. I must have. I can't remember. Anyway, right, left. Your left arm's gonna swing over and meet the right, and your head's going to go with it. Just do that once. Your left knee is going to invert like that and go back out again. So to do that, you want your foot, in fact I'll actually show you on my feet, your foot needs to be on a demi point, so back on the ball of your foot, like what you do with your releves in here, so it's much easier to twist, because if you try and do that on a flat foot, it's much harder to do and it doesn't look as nice. If you put your foot on a demi point, it's much easier to move. Yeah? So if we're here, right arm, left arm, into here, and back. That's all that is. Excuse me. I'll do that again. Right, left, over, and back. And again, that's quite fast. So one and two, three, and tuck, out, out, over, and back. As I said, it's fast. Let's try that, and then I'll try and go through the mechanics of the next bit, because the next bit might be a little bit difficult to wrap your head around. So you've done that bit, going back, four, five. 5, 6, that's 1 8. So 1 and 2, 3 and 4, out, out, over, back. Fast. Try it again. Keep going. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If your elbows are beginning to click when you're doing it, don't worry about it. Mine's do that. So, as I said, it's fast. So you're doing that for, you're doing your shoulder rolls for 1 8. I thought it was 2, it's not, it's 1 8. So you're doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Use 8 to already take that stance that you need for the next bit. Otherwise you'll be rushed off your feet. So from there, it is then straight into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I said, that's fast. From there, I need to move back a touch because small garden. From here, stepping your left foot forward, 1, turning to face the bottom corner of where your left leg is, your left hand bottom corner to here, tucking your right foot into rotiri again, into here, and your hands are going to go here. If you can't snap your fingers, don't worry about it, you can just put them here. So you've done 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, and that's a hop. So you're going 1, 2. Okay? Now you need that hop to get you into the next move, to get you into the last move. It's a lot of jumps. So please be careful. If you do not have the room to do this, just walk through it. Don't try and attempt it. If you have the space, then take a bigger jump as you like. But only if you have the space. Please. I don't want anybody crashing into any chairs. So you've done 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. You step your right foot back down. So I'm moving back so you can see my feet. So you've done 2. You step your right foot down. Step your left foot forward. Windmill your hands over. Thank. Well done. Well done. Let me see what works better actually. I might change the hands. Windmill hands, better. Much more momentum. You've done 5, 6, 7, 8. You're going 1, 2. Stepping your right foot back down again. Stepping your left foot forward. Right hand comes up over first. Over, left hand follows to face the back. So you're pivoting to face the back. And the next bit, I might actually have to kind of do that a touch just so you can properly see my feet. I'll need to move it back for my next class though, because now I'm like this. Once you have done your windmill, over to here, you should have your right foot in front. You're going to step your left foot forward. This is going to be your initial lunge, and you need to push off this back foot, off your right leg. All you're going to do is you're going to push up into a straight jump, half turn towards me. So I'll show you what I mean. From here, all you're doing is that, and that was really bad on my knee. So I'll do that again, a little bit more gently maybe. From here, you're pushing up, both your legs are snapping together like that, and you're landing down in a bend. I have definitely done something to my knee. I will need to have a look at that. And your hands, I'll need to actually turn you back up now. Just, there. Your hands are going to go up and over your head to here, and they should relax when you bend back down again. So I will try and do the jump as best I can with my sore knee. So you've done windmill over, step. It should be a snap of the legs here and relax down to here. Oh, ow. Sorry, just... I might need to... might need to put a little bit of ointment on that, actually, before I go out today. Right. So with that, let's try all of that together as best I can. Maybe do it a couple of times and then move on to our cool down. It's been a small section today, but hopefully it's fun. Just the last section. One more. Okay, I really need to stop doing that. Hopefully my knee will be better for going through that again with you next week. Okay, good thing is there's not a lot of bendy knee sort of stuff in the seniors routine, otherwise I'd be in a lot of trouble. Let's try the full thing with that once through and then we'll do a cool down. Sorry I couldn't do the jump, just I really can't risk putting any more pressure on my knee. I might actually need to wear knee pads next week. Very well done. Let's go into a cool down. Need to put my hoodie over my pad because it's getting too hot now. Feet to the side and head down this time. Oh dear. Have a
I have a message.
Well, thank you very much for taking part again this week, guys. I do apologise if it's been a little bit of a mess. But thank you very much for bearing with me. Really good to see so many of you taking part and joining in and having fun. Hopefully you guys can get outside at some point today, maybe after the class is finished. You can go outside and play with your friends and go to a park maybe, if the weather's like this, especially. But if it's lashing rain outside by the time you get this, then definitely stay inside. Unless you're someone that likes to go out and play puddles. I do love to go out and play puddles. I should go out and play in a puddle. Just go and find one today. There won't be any, but... Thank you guys very much for taking part in this, and I look forward to seeing you all next week. Stay safe.